Hello students, I am Gnaneshwara TN, Assistant Professor of English. In the previous session, I had introduced the short story Engine Trouble written by R.K. Narayan. In this session, I am going to introduce the characters in the story. We see a typical Indian milieu in characterization and building of atmosphere in this story. The first character I am going to introduce is the narrator. The narrator is the only major character in the story. All other characters are minor characters. He is introduced as the talkative man in the beginning of the story. He narrates the story in the first person. The narrator seems to be R.K. Narayan's own self-portrait. Like Narayan, the narrator is a middle-class man struggling to rise above his origins. He says, "I am a poor man," three times in the story. He won a road engine as a prize in a lottery. He felt happy in the beginning, but later he wanted to dispose it of when it becomes a burden for him. Narrator's wife, she is the only female character in the story. When the narrator had to pay rent for the road engine, his wife gave her jewels to her husband to pledge. But when his troubles continued, she lost her temper and cried that she would write to her father to come and take her away. Showman. The showman is the owner of the Gaiety Land, which provided all sorts of fun and gambling and sideshows. He showed no concern when the narrator asked him to help him to transport the road engine. But he agreed to keep the engine on the Gymkhana grounds till the end of their season. Municipal Chairman. When the narrator approached the municipal chairman asking him to buy the road engine, he showed no interest to buy it. One fine evening, the municipal chairman arranged a show in which a Swamiji performed his yogic feats. The Swamiji wanted a road engine to be driven over his chest as the last act. The chairman felt ashamed to acknowledge that he had none. When the Swamiji insisted, he tried to put him off by saying there is no driver. Secretary of the Cosmopolitan Club. The narrator approached the secretary of the Cosmopolitan Club asking him to buy the road engine. But he laughed and asked what he should do with the road engine. Male engine driver. The narrator approached the station master to get the help of the male engine driver to move the road engine from the Gymkhana grounds. But the engine driver pointed out that he had his own locomotive to mind and couldn't think of jumping off at a wayside station for anybody's sake. Joseph was a dismissed bus driver. The narrator took his service to move the road engine from the Gymkhana grounds. Although he knew nothing of road rollers, he agreed to steer the road engine. When it reached the road, it began to move zigzag. The elephant dragged it one way. Joseph turned the wheel without any idea of where he was going. Swamiji. One fine evening, under the patronage of municipal chairman, a show was held in which a Swamiji performed his yogic feats. It was a free performance. He declared that he was carrying on his master's message to the people in that manner. The Swamiji wanted a road engine to be driven over his chest as the last act. The municipality does not have one. The narrator becomes the hero of the hour by lending his engine for the feat, and in return it would be driven wherever he wanted it to. Unfortunately, a police inspector entered the scene. He said that the magistrate had issued an order that Swamiji could do anything except had potassium cyanide or had road engine run over him. The Swamiji got angry and went away in great rage. Swamiji's assistant. Swamiji's assistant had been trained to handle any kind of road engine. After the cancellation of the performance of running the engine over Swamiji's chest, the narrator asked his assistant to take the engine over to his friend's field. He denied to do so, citing the Swamiji's unhappiness over the development. Police inspector. When the Swamiji was preparing for his last performance, that is the road engine to run over his chest, a police inspector came into the crowd with a brown envelope in his hand. He held up his hand, beckoned to the Swamiji's assistant and told that the magistrate had issued an order prohibiting the engine from running over the Swamiji. Owner of the compound wall. While the narrator attempting to move the road engine with the help of a dismissed bus driver, a temple elephant and 50 coolies, in that confused dragging, the engine hit a compound wall, reducing a good length of it to powder. The owner of the compound slapped the narrator in the face and got him arrested by the police. Owner of the well. One night, an earthquake hit the town. In the morning, when the narrator visited the place where the machine stood, he found that it was not there. Due to the earthquake, it had been dragged into an unused well. The owner of the well thanked the narrator because he wanted to close the well. So, he agreed to pay all the expenses on the man's behalf and requested him to leave the machine there. He agreed to withdraw all complaints and charges against him. Coolies. The narrator hired 50 coolies to push the engine from behind. The coolies wanted 8 annas per head. When the engine reached the road, it began to move zigzag. The elephant dragged it one way. Joseph turned the wheel without any idea of where he was going, and 50 men behind it clung to it every possible manner and pushed it just where they liked. As a result, the engine ran straight into the opposite compound wall and reduced a good length of it to powder. The elephant kicked down a further length of the wall. The 50 men fled in panic. Dear students, let us recall what we have learnt in this session. The narrator is the only major character in the story. He is introduced as the talkative man in the beginning of the story. He says, "I am a poor man," 3 times in the story. The showman is the owner of the Gaiety land. Joseph was a dismissed bus driver. Although he knew nothing of road rollers, he agreed to steer the road engine. Swamiji was carrying on his master's message to the people by performing his yogic feats. Swamiji's assistant had been trained to handle any kind of road engine. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.